Hey guys, Justo the Chad here, and today we're doing our first episode of the Chelsea Road to Glory. So I have this little pop-up around me right here, and it's on this side like this. And so let's just get into the rules. So the rules are every single Chelsea player I have has to be in the starting 11, and then once I have more than 11 Chelsea players, I can make it a different arrangement, etc. Every single Chelsea player I have has to be at least in the like starting 11 and bench and everything like that. I can't just choose someone and then never play him. And so we have little like rewards for every single game. So for the very first game, if I score a goal or win or anything, I get a player. So just to start off the Chelsea thing. And so if I win, I get the next Chelsea player in order. So it'll be bronze in the beginning and work our way up. If I get a goal with anyone on their debut, so normally it's going to be a Chelsea player, I do get the next Chelsea player in line as well. And if I get a hat trick with anyone on the team, even if it's a starting bronze, I do get another Chelsea player in the order. And if I win by three or more, I get any Chelsea player I want with as much coins as I have. So I believe right now I have around 3,000 to 4,000 coins just because it's not my first game playing on that account. And so we'll work with that just to help us because there are a lot of expensive Chelsea players. And then if I get a rage quit, I just get the next Chelsea player in order. And if I get a clean sheet, I do get the next Chelsea player. And then if I lose, I lose the lowest rated Chelsea player in all of them. So the goals is to win the Division 1 title and get every single Chelsea player. And that includes informs, etc. And so when I want to buy an inform, I will sell the original player to get the inform just to help with coins and everything like that. And I'm not going to be purchasing coins or anything like that on this account, so it will take a while for me to get to the higher rated players. And I'll be doing this until FIFA 18 comes out, and then I'll be going to FIFA 18. And I might continue on FIFA 18 with the Chelsea Road to Glory idea, but we're not sure. Also, with the win by any three, I can get any Chelsea player, or I can change that to getting the next two Chelsea players in a row. Now that we're done with the, and we have the top goal scorers along the bottom here, and I'll be updating that at the end of each episode. So yeah, without further ado, let's get into the gameplay. Alright, so we're going to go through our starting lineup. So we have Hanato as our left striker, Minagawa as our right striker, Ovenstad as our cam, Ricardo as our left winger, and then we have Ahashim as our right winger. Don't know how to say that name. Uruk as our right back. Traore is our center back. Paradin is our other center back. And then we have the beast Antagana as our center defensive mid. And Lelung as our left back. And then I switch out my goalkeeper because I see on my bench I have a 62 rated Bachman as my goalkeeper. And so he will be our starting goalkeeper. Alright, so yeah. That's the starting lineup. And we go into the first game. And we are against a Spanish, just an all-gold team. So they have Sergio as their goalkeeper with Morata, but from Real Madrid, as a striker. So basically an enemy because he is Chelsea now. And yeah, so we're going to start off and get him the kickoff. And right away, I was on his half for most of the time, as you guys will see. So it starts off, and he goes and runs up in our team, and I actually snag the ball pretty soon, and I'm able to play it out, move the ball pretty quickly. We had a lot of aggressive, that's my center back way up there, so it was a very aggressive team, and I lose the ball, but I'm able to get it back, and just slowly playing like tiki-taka almost, and I kept losing the ball, but I kept getting it back too, so. And then here we end up losing the ball, but it falls nicely to my attacking midfielder, who's going to take a shot. And it deflects to our right winger, who's going to play it back and tries to square it into the middle, where it messes up. And then Ovenstad has another chance and completely spoons it, so that was unlucky. And then we see here he's going to get a goal kick, and he messes up right away. And so my player is actually able to get in front and tries a shot, and not the best shot. I probably could have just taken it backwards and then made a better shot. Anyways, we do get a corner from it. And Sirigu does get his hand to the corner, and my guy, Ovenstad, is able to get there first. But then he loses it for a throw-in. And as you can see here, my player was not that technically good, and he throws it over his player's head right to mine, and I end up messing up here, but I get the ball back, and I play into the middle, and I see Ricardo, my left winger, making a great run, and I get it to him, he takes the shot, and I'm lucky not there to score there. Sergio did a great stop. And then here, we have, back here, we have Ricardo plays it off to Ontagawa, who sends a great through ball to my right winger, Ahashine. And then this is probably one of my best finishes ever. I just chip him from 18 yards out perfectly, and that was a great bronze versus gold right there. So that was an awesome shot. Definitely up there for goal of the series so far. And yeah, we are looking strong going into this. Just, I was so happy when I was able to make that too. Alright, and then we are in the 25th minute. I get the ball here with Ricardo, played off to Ovenstad, who sees the great run going up top, so I chip it over to Hanato, the goalkeeper runs out, and I play it back, and I still don't know how I didn't make that. That was a given opportunity, and I don't know how he misses that header, but unlucky there. And here he has Bojan on the left, and he just out-dribbled me so hard. There's two guys on him, and he gets away from them both, and is able to square it across, and then plays it back. And then the guy's wide open here, and he somehow misses. I think that was Vargas who took the shot. And so great stop by my goalie, Bachmann. And then here, Bojan just takes it out of play. So that was his only first chance, really, the first half. And then he gets the ball here with Pareto, and is able to just destroys me dribbling here. That was insane. Lays off Morata, and there's three guys on Morata, and just, it was a great shot. Fair play to him. I mean, I had three guys on him, and he put that top corner, so completely beat every single one of my players, and that was just, he got back into that with that, look at that, just a great finish. So we start off, and here, and towards the end of the second half, I thought I got a foul right there, but they does call for halftime, so it's halftime. I don't make any subs this game, just because I really like my defensive midfield, and my defense, what I thought was doing very strong, it was just that unlucky play right there, and I definitely deserve the lead, I think. I'm not leading right yet, so that's a little frustrating, but we go out here in the second half, and yeah. So this play, I get it with Minagawa, and I lay it off to Ovenstad, who takes the shot, unlucky not to go in, and then his defender plays it right back to mine, and I try finding Minagawa, unable to, and he's going through. The great pass move. He's really good at passing like that, and he sees Morata go through. Hits him perfectly, and I was very scared right here because Morata had great finishing, and I stutter step there, unlucky not to get that, and he squares it perfectly across, and I thought that was a goal, but he misses it, and so I got very lucky there. And here he's playing with Pareto, hits Morata, and this is probably the most unlucky goal you ever see. It just goes right off his elbow and back in. So I was pretty upset because now I was losing this game too, so I had to think about getting back into it. And here, I believe in like the 63rd or 64th minute, I do get the ball out here with Ovenstad and play to Minagawa, and then back to Ovenstad, who finds Hanato, who does lose the ball and then gets it back, takes a shot, crazy deflection, and then look at this finish. Perfectly in the bottom corner. Probably one of the craziest goals I've ever seen. I scored two of the best goals in this game I've ever scored. Like, that lucky deflection, everything, and I just slot it home with a 57-rated Ricardo. So, I definitely was impressed with Ricardo this game, so. And yeah, so that's how the game ended. It was really boring the second half, to be fair. He does have a chance here, but I'm able to clear it away. And then I thought I had a chance, and so I send it forward, but it's called right then. So yeah, deserve to win that one, unlucky not to, but that's what happens, right? I do have to say, my defensive midfielder, Ontagawa, right there, number 19, was outstanding, and my Minagawa striker was pretty good too. Hanato did okay, but Minagawa was definitely the up man, and Ricardo was good. My team played a really good performance, so that was nice. And so, because I said that we get the first player no matter what, since we did tie, I counted it as getting a debut goal, and I just counted one. And so, we do pick up the lowest rated Chelsea player, which is goalkeeper Beanie. So we do take out Bachmann and put in Beanie as our goalie. And he is worse than Bachmann, but he is Chelsea, so I have faith. And so we come up against Footy's Butlin and Footy Smalling, John Terry, Dele Alli as Cam, and then Ashley Long and Oxlade as the outside wingers with Bakambu and Onlone Royce as the two outside wingers, or forwards, I should say. And so this guy definitely had speed on his side. In the beginning here, I have a good chance here with a free kick, and yeah, that's the bronze thing, so. But here, he passes it out and gives it right to Hanato, who gets it with Minigawa, and I lay it into the middle to my Ovenshan Cam, who just puts that perfectly into the corner. And so, with that mess up of a goal kick, I'm able to score, and that was in the 42nd minute, and so I finally was able to score on him. And in the 44th minute, I do get the ball from him. With Ovenstein, I play the ball to my other striker, Hanato, and then I chip it over with Minigawa, perfectly to Hanato, who just puts it perfectly in the corner. A low driven pass in. I mean, I was really happy about that. So I made it a 42nd 0-0 half to a 45th 2-0, which was outstanding. And I did get a little reward here on my new account, so that was awesome. And then in the 58th minute, I do get the ball here to Ovenstein, lay it off to Minigawa, and he slides from behind with Matip as his center back, and he was already on a yellow card, and so he does receive a second yellow card and is sent off, which was pretty good. I felt like I could definitely get the win by three now, especially with him having 10 men. He does have a scary chance here, and I'm actually able to get it. I made subs on halftime for my two midfielders, and I do here try playing the ball with Ricardo. It bounces off the defender perfectly to my other striker, and the goalkeeper does come out, and I do a little cheeky pass in just to secure the 3-0 win, so that was great. And so that was my, I subbed him in as my attacking midfielder, Shihan, I believe is how you pronounce it, and so it was a great goal from him. I'm not counting as a debut goal, I only count Chelsea goals as debut goals now, after the first game, so. Hanato here plays it to Ricardo, who's going to chip the defender right there to play to Hanato. And then here I take a good finish, deflect it off, and Minigawa is there to put it away, so that was awesome. My team was just on the fence right now, so that was great. A good goal here too. I thought he was going to rage quit eventually, but here in the 87th minute, I get it to Minigawa again. The defender falls to the ground, and I just slot it home. So Minigawa is definitely a top-class finisher for my bronze team. yeah, just able to turn him around. He was sliding towards the end too, so that was kind of upsetting. But then here in the 94th minute, I do a great passing move, play to Hanato, who plays to Ricardo, and I try hitting a great through ball, but it does slow down a little bit, so Hashim has to wait a little bit. And I do play the ball in and find Hanato, and I do lay it back on accident to Ricardo, but he's still able to slot it home. I definitely got scared there because I had pressed A right there with Hanato, and he took like three extra touches and then played to Ricardo. And Ricardo here like is aiming for the right side of the post, but he's able to still make it. And so Minigawa was able to pick up two goals there, and Ricardo was able to pick up his second goal. So they're both sitting at two goals for two games, which is outstanding. And here in the last game, we go against a MLS team. And so I thought this would be the easiest of the three matches, but I was definitely wrong. I was outplayed by a lot. In the first half, I thought I could keep it at a like 0-0 first half. But as you can see here, he does come at me in the 20th minute and play to David Villa, and my defense just right there, just completely open by Giovanni Dos Santos, and he does hit the post in and goes in. So I did forget to show you guys, but I did bring in a center attacking midfielder Mount as my attacking midfielder. I brought in a center back for Chelsea, and I do bring in another goalkeeper, so I put Beanie as striker, and he did really well as me for striker. We did lose, but he still played well for me. So right now, my teammate's able to get the ball here, and he plays it to Dos Santos, who plays it to Amarone, and he's
Almiron is just going to take it all the way down, and watch this. My goalkeeper stops it, and my defender lets the guy go by, and he scores an easy tap-in. So that was very unlucky, and it was right before halftime, too, so I wasn't really super proud of that. But we're going to keep going. And so at this moment, I was almost certain that my goalkeeper was going to be the lowest-rated Chelsea player, and so I kind of like Beanie, and so I'm totally fine with losing a goalkeeper this round, because we do have another one that we can put in, so that's fine. So right here, Beanie makes a nice play, unlucky not to score there. We get the ball back, we lose it, and then he's going to take with Almiron to Nogbe, back to Almiron, and then he loses it here again. And then going forward, Piatti is going to take it all the way down the wing, and I foolishly slide tackle right there. So he's able to get around me, crosses it in, and Dos Santos just makes a great header into the corner, and my goalkeeper can't do anything about that. And that was in the 76th minute, and yeah, that's basically all she wrote. After that, there were no real chances, and so unfortunately, in our third game, we do lose 3-0, so that means we are going to be losing the lowest rated player. And yeah, so that's unfortunate. And so if we look here, the lowest rated player is in fact Collins, our goalkeeper, so we are going to go and put him on the transfer list, and so that means we'll just have to get him back next game, since he is now the lowest player in the club, or lowest player to get for Chelsea now. Alright guys, so now our top goal scorers are Ricardo with 2 goals, Minagawa 2 goals as well, Ashim with 1 goal, Hanatu with 1 goal, and Ovenstad with 1 goal. Alright, hope you guys enjoyed. Like and subscribe for more. See ya.